Mpanga from Tanzania. I represent Tanzania Socialist Forum.
What is for you very particular to this conference? What is particular, what is distinctive in this conference comparing with other conferences you attended previously?
Okay, for first, this is my second conference.
Okay.
Because the first conference I attended in Europe was the one in Dar es Salaam. So this is actually the second one. Well, in terms of the difference,
yes.
I mean, I'll first start with what I think hasn't gone well before I get to that. See, the conference in Dar es Salaam, the way I felt, it was more engaging. Like there were enough time for interactions, people could make more intervention, you see. Though the space wasn't that enough, but at least in comparison with this one, there at least people had time to for more engagement and interaction and that. So I think maybe this one here, I feel like the time has been a little bit limited. Plus, maybe with the arrangements that we had four panelists, while the time was a bit short, that a little bit limited some other people from the ground for more engagement and intervention. But in terms of what is right, I think it is also quite informative. I've been enjoying all the topics, all the topics that comrades have been presenting. There has been a very rich experiences from the comrades from the ground who are directly engaged within the struggle. Like this morning, I really liked the session about the land struggles and the way the comrades were speaking about their real experiences in the ground, how they're being impeded by the law, how women's rights are being so and so marginalized, the way the traditional leaders at times collude with the government officials to continue making this whole person of land struggle a bit problematic. It was really, really nice for me and I really loved it.
And what did you learn which maybe will be useful for you in the struggle you are doing in your country?
Well, a lot of things will be so useful. First, the information, because spaces like this for us activists, they're mainly for learning. So like I've learned a lot. There's a lot of experience that I'll carry back home to my organization, plus a lot of information about how other comrades struggle in other spaces with the matters that we are also struggling for. Because as you can see, all the key issues for our struggle are almost similar. There are land struggles in South Africa. We also have land struggles in Tanzania. Although the scale may be different, the way the land question is in Tanzania and South Africa could be completely different, but being it a problem, we all share it. So at least how the comrades in South Africa organize when it comes to the land struggles, their experiences, how do they battle with the state, with these parliamentarians, what are their thoughts about the legal path when it comes to the struggles against the land and all those kind of things. I think I've learned quite a lot along those areas, and being a member of an organization which works directly with the grassroots movements, and of course I coordinate the grassroots department, I think I've had a lot to take to my department.
And in the grassroots movement you are working with, what is the contributions of women? Women in your organization?
In my organization? Well, like as is generally known, women have always been in the forefront of the struggle, like in most cases. Like, so even in my organization. So even in my organization, women are actually playing a very big role when it comes to organization and engagement in the struggle. Although we don't have, as it is usual, like everywhere, you usually find that the number of women within the organization is usually very little due to various difficulties, we understand. When it comes to the family responsibilities, always a woman, if you've started a family, you have a lot of roles to play with it. I mean, sometimes it kind of limits your space for engagement. So that could have been one of the reasons why we have a few number of female comrades within the organization. But then even with those few, they play a very, very great role of mobilization and organization. That it is the female comrades that at times go to the grassroots to meet the people in the communities, to get to know and learn about their struggles and see how they could actually get that connected to the organization. But again, we also have the female comrades within these sort of committees, like I've told you, within the coordination committee. When you try to look at the level of commitment between the male and female comrades, it's usually the female comrades are more committed into the cause. They're always there for the struggle. They can always give up a lot of things, devote their time for the struggle whenever they have it, as compared to the male comrades. So to the large extent, much work, I'm not trying to say that the male comrades are not doing anything, but much work, like the really groundwork, the real organization, the really practical of whatever we theorize and discuss, in most cases, is being done by female comrades.
Which message would you like to share with people who are listening to you?
Well, as a militant, or I would say a young female militant, I would just love to tell other comrades that as a young generation, like what I said yesterday, as a young generation, we are the ones with enough energy to engage in the struggle. Like, this is our time to be full committed within the struggle. So I would just love to tell them, especially the young comrades, that we are not the future, we're the current. It's now that we have to really, really engage with the struggle. It's now that we need to really work towards the change that we want to see within our societies. So we need to drive this revolutionary agenda and walk the talk of the revolution, like really, by really practicing it within the ground. We do not need to wait for future for us to start engaging, because we are the current.
Thank you very much.